Well, you know, I think I've droned on long enough.
I just heard what happened. I wanted to offer my condolences to the team. Quark's loss is a true tragedy. The man was a hero. Brave, honest, kind, and humble to the core.
What a load of bullsh.
What should I do? I cannot take this anymore. How could Princess Velvet depart on her own?
Velvet?
How do you like the subterranean village? It was really difficult getting it all down here. Other nations are battling to control the areas above ground, so keep this place a secret.
Newcomer, I shall have you help us collect the coins. Remember that this country produced 3 types of magical coins. This is Valentinian gold. This is an aerial coin. It has a picture of Velvet and Ingwe's mother, see? And finally, these commemorative coins were made to celebrate the spell cast on all of them. Welcome! What can I get you today? With pleasure. Will this be all? With pleasure. Will this be? Thank you very much. Welcome. What can I get you today? With pleasure. Will this be all for you? Thank you very much.
Is there something you need? Is there something you...
You should go back. I must be on my way.
I should not have told you about the cauldron.
It creates pure magic. And the Vanir and the Aesir are fighting a war over it. The princess snuck out onto the battlefield alone in order to stop it. I'm so nervous. Princess Velvet.
Why are you so concerned about Princess Velvet?
I can't tell you now. In any case, the Aesir and the Vanir are nearby, fighting over the crystallization cauldron. Why has the princess gone out at a time like this?
It is because the late King Valentine has returned to this world. The cauldron is still active, but it is like being asleep. But that man can manipulate the cauldron like he did during the disaster.
This disaster? When this land was destroyed and its people turned into pukas? What kind of king wishes for the destruction of his own country?
The cauldron ruined Valentine. That nightmare may become reality once again. The only one able to stop King Valentine will be the princess. She knew him.
I have a magic sword. Don't worry about me. I'll help save the princess. Oh, Velvet. Even if we meet, you won't be able to recognize me. But I shall protect you, even if you don't know me.
Thank you. could charge extra since this is a battlefield, but it's very dangerous. I could have 9 lives and it still wouldn't be enough. I'll make you a deal.
Restaurant. No building, no problem.
When I come here, I am reminded of that terrifying day.
Mind me not. I see you have a new recipe. Please, allow me. Now then, what do you want to order? Is there anything else you want to order?
Thank you. You're the Puka from before. This is a combat zone. You should leave. Lord Brigand's troops are here and will be attacking soon.
Huh! Thank you. neutral in this war. I'm just a businessman. In this bloodstained land, the stakes are high, but the profits are higher.
I see you, Evan. Now then. Very well. Will that be all? As you wish. Is there anything else you... Thank you very much. Thank you.
I'm new, not in this.
Ah!
sure you've realized by now that escape is impossible. Now give me back that ring. I promised to protect it. I cannot let anyone have it. This ring, it controls the cauldron. I must stop the cauldron. He is nearby right now. Who are you talking about? The cauldron's controller. The ring's owner, Valentine. He cannot control it again. It will repeat a tragedy. You're making excuses in order to keep the ring to yourself. This is what you get.
Princess Velvet!
Puka, I beg of you, please get the ring.
The ring?
Protect it. Give it to no one. Listen, give me my ring. This weapon is a magic bow. It only takes one shot.
You hurt the princess. You're acting like a child. I'll let it slide. Go away.
Don't take me for a fool. I don't fear you, Puka. I won't forgive you.
Velvet, are you all right?
I see. My granddaughter yet lives.
Puka, do not come this way. Take the ring and escape.
No, that spirit I helped.
I must thank you. I managed to escape back to this world without being caught by that pale woman.
That crown... So you must be...
I am the King of Valentine. The cauldron is my heart, and the titril, my throne. The ring has been returned to its rightful owner.
Grandfather, please think about this.
You and your brother escaped the curse. You can't comprehend what it's like. This pain and suffering. Neither can Odin, nor the fairies, nor all of Titania. They must see hell firsthand.
You want the world to end?
Take a good look at me. All I want is oblivion. Yes, the world's demise. Just like the prophecies, the lid to hell opens. The time has now come.
It seems that all the rational thinking fell out of that bony skull of yours.
Damn, Puka. Do you think waving some magic sword from Titania around makes you a hero? Watch your mouth. Kneel, fool. I am your king.
You were never my king.
You fool. Intruding on us? This isn't over. You hear?
Princess.
Thank you. Thank you, Puka.
Princess Velvet, I wanted to see you. 'Tis me, Cornelius. No, I can't. She can't love me when I'm like this. I can't tell her. Just close your mouth and endure the pain. But for how long?
Oh, here you are. You jumped out of bed the instant you woke up. How do you feel? I think you should get more rest.
The princess, how is she?
Princess Velvet brought you back here.
Where is she?
She's not here right now. She was in a hurry to leave.